Some days life feels perfect, other days it just ain't working. The good, the bad, the right, the wrong, and everything in between. Yo, it's crazy, amazing, we can turn our heart through the words we say. Mountains crumble with every syllable.
God shows up on every trip because he's already there, and that's really exciting because whenever you go to a new country, God's already there. It's not you're bringing God, he's already there. So. The best part of the trip for me is always just forming relationships with the people that we're serving. They're such amazing people, and you can learn so much from them despite like the language barrier. It's just a really great experience.
I don't, I will, I won't. It's like I'm drowning in the deep. Well, it's crazy to imagine words from my lips as the arms of compassion. Mountains crumble with every syllable. Hope can live or die. So speak life.
Showed up on this trip in a lot of ways, but the way that I most remember it is when we were building the house, we were making a lot of noise, so the neighbors and the community were kind of wondering what we were doing. So the first couple of days they would peek their head through the fence and kind of watch what we were doing, but by the third day a lot of the neighbors were involved, and God was really just showing me that this is how his kingdom is. He uses people from all over the world, all over the nations, every race, every tribe, to build up his house.
And raise your thoughts a little higher. Use your words to inspire. Joy will fall like rain when you speak life with the things you say. Lift your head a little higher. Spread the love like fire.
Most memorable part of the trip to me was when we were handing the keys over to the house and I gave the Bible to the mom, and when I gave her a hug, I just felt like my shirt starting to get wet, and she was just bawling in my arms, and that hug was at least 2 minutes long, and that just like stuck out to me because I was looking throughout the whole trip like to see where God could work in my life. And then that last day when I gave her the Bible, that just completely changed my life to see how much the work that we did over that week changed her life.
Something that I learned about myself is that I don't appreciate the little things in life, because the people don't have anything, or they're just so happy for people just to be nice to them, and I just want like all these material things. But that was something that I learned about myself, and I don't say thank you enough.
Tell me, everybody, believe in love. Do you believe in love? Yes, I want to know if you believe in love. Tell me you believe in love. Don't let me change your mind. Say that love is gone.
The best part of the trip is probably the first 2 days. Even though we spend it traveling, we spend a lot of time together as a team and bonding. We play so many games, and it's the best part of the trip because we become a family in that time. And God shows up there, and we get to know about each other and about each other's hearts, and that's my favorite time.
Everybody, you believe in love. Do you believe in love? Yes, I want to know if you believe in love. Tell me you believe in love. Don't let me change your mind. Your mind. Tell your love has had its day. Love's come back. It's alive and well. No matter what the people say. Yeah.
To describe the trip in one word or phrase, it would probably be life-changing. And after the trip, once I got home, it was really eye-opening. Because Greece was so poor, and just the refugees had absolutely nothing to their name. And just coming back and having all of these things just right there for me, it was just really eye-opening, because, you know, we live in such a, you know, plentiful world here, and everywhere else is just, they have nothing. And